Hello, this is Julian, and in this video, I'm going to explain you whether you should learn Vyper or Solidity for Ethereum smart contract. So Solidity is really the standard on Ethereum. Most developers know this programming language. Most companies need a developer with Solidity skills, and most developer tools are designed for Solidity first. So for example, Truffle was first designed for Solidity. Open Zeppelin, the framework for smart contract, is also written in Solidity. So by choosing Solidity, really, I would say that you make your life easier, and it's just going to be much more compatible with everything. However, there are some problems with Solidity. For example, the syntax sometimes is not really clear. Also, it's not very easy to audit the smart contract to make sure that it's safe. So that's why there are some programmers who decided to create an alternative smart contract language called Vyper. So the design objective of Vyper is first simplicity. So its syntax is like Python, and it's actually easier to read some Vyper code compared to Solidity. And second, it's also easier to audit a Vyper smart contract, so that's very important for security. So this is for the positive aspect, but there are also some negative aspects. So for example, in Vyper, the language is still a bit primitive compared to Solidity. For example, you don't have dynamic arrays, so it's a little bit difficult to work around this. Also, you don't have an inline assembly, so you cannot really do very low-level stuff. And also, you don't have modifiers for your smart contract, and there are like a few features that are missing in Vyper, and the reason they're not present is because the creator of Vyper thought that these features were a way for programmers to take some risks, so they wanted to eliminate this. But there are also, for me, the two most important disadvantages of Vyper are: one, most of the development tools in the Ethereum community, they are not compatible with Vyper. So for example, you don't have an equivalent of Open Zeppelin written in Vyper. So that means that many times you will have to re-implement some smart contract of Open Zeppelin, but in Vyper, but by doing so, your smart contract will probably be less secure than the audited Solidity code of Open Zeppelin, and that kind of defeat the purpose of having a better security for Vyper to begin with. And second, another problem I see is that you have many companies that actually don't need Vyper skills. So as a developer, if you want to find a blockchain job, it's going to be a little bit more difficult to monetize your skills in Vyper as opposed to Solidity. Also, for Windows user, Vyper is not so easy to install on Windows. Windows is definitely a second class citizen for Vyper, and a large part of blockchain developers are still are using Windows. So not really good for these guys. So I would say my advice is, first, you need to learn Solidity if you are new to Ethereum and smart contract, and only after you can start to learn Vyper for fun if you want. But I don't really recommend you to write production smart contract in Vyper. It's still an sort of alternative to Solidity, but that's not really the most easy to use, the most compatible. By the way, if you are interested in Solidity, I've prepared a short email course of 5 emails where I give you my best tips for Solidity. So if you want to put your hand on that, all you have to do is to follow the link in the description and I'll send you this. I hope that this video was useful for choosing whether you should learn Solidity or Vyper. If you have any question, then post them down below in the comment. And thanks for watching, and see you for the next video. Bye bye.